Okay, Bismillah. I'm ready. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulihil amin. Sayyidina wa habibina Muhammad. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'du. And welcome back to our program, Calling to Peace with me, Imam Shamsi Ali. Today I'm going to talk about some principle or basic characteristics of Al-Islam. As you may know, that Islam is the religion which is followed by over 1.6 billion people around the world. Islam possibly, in one hand, is the most popular faith, tradition or religion. But at the same time, we have found in the past that Islam had been the most misunderstood religion in the world. Therefore, it is very important for us to talk about it. What Islam really means? And what are the characteristics of Al-Islam? I would like to begin today by quoting an ayah from Surah Al-Ma'idah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today I had perfected your religion and I have completed my favor upon you and had made Islam as your faith, with your religion. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirms and affirms that Islam is the religion of perfection. It is perfect deen. It's perfect religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, the first characteristic of Al-Islam is that it is kamilun. This is the religion that covers every single aspect of human's life. We are Muslims not only in the masajid. We are being Muslims not only in the month of Ramadan. We are Muslims not only in holy places in Mecca or Medina. We are Muslims in 24 hours, 7 days, everywhere, every time. Islam covers our life individually, collectively. Islam covers our life ritually and socially. Islam covers our life in and out, from head to toe. And that is the meaning of when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the believers to enter into the fold of Islam completely. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, udkhulu fi silmi kaffa, enter into the religion of Islam fully, not half and partially. Not only that we are becoming Muslim and we are praying ritually to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in nutshell, the perfection of Islam can be seen in two aspects. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الظِّلَّةِ أَيْنَمَا ثُقِفُ إِلَّا بِحَبْلٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَحَبْلٍ مِّنَ النَّاسِ. We cannot live our life honorably. We cannot live our life with dignity and respect without building a very strong connection, number one, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hablum min Allah. And therefore we pray 5 times daily, alhamdulillah. We form hajj, we do adhkar, we do qiyamul layl, different tasabih, make dua. All these are a part of our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But of course, more important, that we feel the presence of Allah in our life. But at the same time, we cannot only help building relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but forget our relation with other people around us. So the Quran says, وَحَبْلٍ مِّنَ النَّاسِ, with connection with other people around. And therefore, brothers and sisters, the symbols of our salat, for example, as an example, when we pray, we begin our salat by raising our hands. Allahu Akbar. That represents our deep connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But why we want to end our salat? We have to sit down, and then we end our salat by turning to the right, and turning our faces to the left, and say salam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Representing that our salat will not and cannot be accepted without building a good relations with other people around us. And therefore our greetings, my brothers, when you say assalamu alaikum, is not a slogan. It is a commitment to spread peace to everyone else around us. And therefore, we see that the next characteristic of Islam is not only perfect, but also interconnected. What does it mean interconnected? You cannot separate one aspect of Islamic teaching from the other aspect of Islamic teaching. So you cannot say that, oh, mashallah, I'm a good Muslim in my salat. I'm a good Muslim when I do my fasting. I'm a good Muslim when I'm doing my Hajj. But I don't have to be Muslim when I'm in the market. I don't have to be a good Muslim while I'm talking to my friends. Or I don't have to be a good Muslim in thinking about my brothers and sisters. So it's okay for me to have negative thinking. Islam is interconnected. Anything that we do in terms of rituals all lead us into building human character, akhlaqul kareem. Allah says about salat, for example, inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar. That salat is preventing us from any bad and any sin. Because our salat basically is a way for us to build a strong and close connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how it is possible for us to commit mistake, to lie to our brothers, to cheat our brothers, to insult our brothers, while we are so close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While we are believing that we are with Allah, ma'iyatullah, inna allaha ma'ana, wa huwa ma'akum aynama takunu. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says regarding the salat, al-ihsan an ta'bud Allah ka'annaka tarahu, fa in lam takun tarahu fa innahu yara. The concept of ihsan must be present during our prayer. But the concept of ihsan is not only that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but that ihsan is a strong belief that we are really together with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is with us. The company of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us strong, keep us motivated, keep us courageous in life, because we are with the one who created the heavens and the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in whose hands all the dominions, in whose hands all the power, and He is powerful on everything. بِيَدِهِ الْمُلْكِ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters, this is the second characteristic of Al-Islam, that we have to connect the all aspects of Islamic teaching into one building of Islam. You cannot follow just the foundation, that you build the five pillars of Islam. بُنِيَ الْإِسْلَامُ عَلَى خَمْسٍ Islam is built on five pillars. You have shahada, shahadati Allah ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah. You have your prayer, you have your fasting, you have your zakat, you perform hajj. But then you forget to build your Islam in the other aspect of life. That's just like when you build a building. You have the foundation, but you don't have the wall, you don't have the roof, you don't have the window, you don't have the doors. Your building is not enough. And therefore, Islam is not only the pillars, not only five pillars. Islam is a complete building of human's life. And therefore, any rituals that we do must lead us into a building a good human character. Akhlaqul Karima. As you may know, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Holy Quran very highly. But the high praise in the Holy Quran is not about his salat. It's not about his fasting. It's not about his zakat or hajj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Holy Quran by his human character, human conduct. That is what we call in Al-Islam, Al-Akhlaq Al-Karima. Wa innaka la'ala khuluqin azim. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are indeed on a very beautiful, very great human character. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, uswatun hasan. Laqad kana lakum fi Rasulillahi uswatun hasan. is a good example for us to follow in terms of human character. So my point here that do not separate between the aspect of Islamic teaching. Do not be Muslim in the masjid, then in the market you're not Muslim. Do not be Muslim in the month of Ramadan, then the 11 months you tend not to be Muslims. We must keep our Islam every time, every moment, because all these are connected. So let me end with this. When we separate the aspect of Islamic teaching, we are going to have a double standard personality. And that's why you see sometimes the people and ourselves Muslims, sometimes you see some people are becoming so religious, but also on the other hand, they are not religious at all. They are so humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, crying, making dua, sometimes in front of Multazam, in Makkah, in Masjid al-Haram. But the moment they got back to their countries, they are becoming so corrupt. This is a double standard personality. Why it happened to the people, the double standard personality? Because they separate the aspect of Islamic teaching. So once again, Islam is a perfect religion and Islam is interconnected. Between one aspect to another aspect cannot be separated. And hopefully we can follow Islam in this way. We will continue talking about the characteristic of Islam, inshallah, in our program, Calling Islam to Islam to the Peace, with me, Imam Shamsi Ali. It is enough for today. See you again tomorrow. Hadanallahu wa iyyakum ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.